Hey guys, it's Scott with House in Progress. Today we're going to be showing you how to install a USB wall outlet. This is so that you can plug in your cell phone right in the kitchen here without having to carry around a charger. This is a 2 out of 5 on our difficulty scale, and we'll walk you through the whole process. So let's get started. All right, so because this is an electrical project, the first step is always to find your breaker box and shut off the breaker associated with the part of the house that you're working in. We're going to be testing this out with a voltmeter just to make sure that we've killed all power to this outlet, and so we're sticking the red side into the small slot and the black side into the large slot. It can also go into the hole of this outlet, and that'll tell us. As long as the reading's below 1 volt, we should be fine. Normally it's 120. Then we're removing the old faceplate and the old outlet by unscrewing and pulling this away from the wall. Then we're just going to remove the old screws here that are holding these wires into place. If you've got these wires pushed into the back of the outlet and are not screwed in, there should be little slots that you can stick a small tool into, and that will release the wires. So this is our USB outlet that we're going to be installing. We're going to remove it from the packaging. Probably a good idea to look over your instruction manual just to make sure there's not any caveats with the particular USB one that you're using. What I'm doing here is I'm having to bend my wires straight. We're not going to be screwing them into the outlet like we had before. They're going to be actually sliding into a small slot, so we need them in a straight configuration rather than a rounded one. On the back here, we've got a little sizing diagram that shows us how long our wires need to be for the particular application that we're installing it into. So we're going to go ahead and trim these wires up to the appropriate size indicated on the back of that instrument there. And then we're going to reattach our ground wire to the ground screw. It's going to be the green screw on the USB outlet. Just screw that back into place, make sure it's really nice and tight. And in our case, we're going to be sliding these into the small slots on the side of the screw instead of wrapping around the screw, since we have two wires here. And the reason that we have two wires is we've got one wire that's actually bringing power in from the electrical box, and then we've got one that's sending power down to the rest of the wall where there's more outlets in place coming off of this wire. So that's why there's two there. And then we're just going to kind of have to manhandle these wires to get them into a orientation that makes it easier to push this outlet into place. This is always the worst part. You really want to try and set yourself up for success by bending those wires and making it just so you can push this outlet back into place. Of course, you want the outlet to be flush with the wall, so you might need to kind of push it around a little bit, screw it into place. Once you've got that, we're going to put our new faceplate into place here. That'll cover everything up and finish it nicely. Screw that back into place. And so that's really all there is to this project. We turned our breaker back on. We'll plug in a USB cable to my phone here. It powers on. That means we're good to go. Thanks for watching.
Today we got a quick tip.
Not a quick tip.
Got with House in Progress.
Did I give you the go?
I thought you just kept recording like we said we were gonna be doing.